Hello everyone, let's continue with our session, and in this video we will implement card pull system. So let's talk about the card pull system. So this is a bi-charm environment. So we will use this as the IDE to run the reinforcement. So the card pull system is a classic problem of reinforcement learning. So the system consists of a poll acting which acts like an inverted pendulum attached to a card using a joy. So the system is controlled by applying a force of +1 and -1 to the card, and the force apply to the card can be controlled, and the object and the purpose is to swing the pole upward and stabilize it. This must be done without the card falling to the ground. At every step, the agent can choose to move the card left or right, and it receives a reward of 1 for every time step that the pole is balanced. So I think I said this one would be better, and if the poles ever devious by more than 15 degrees from upright, the procedure ends. So that is a little bit of introduction, and of course we will use the OpenAI. So OpenAI Gym library. So now let's write some code for that. So first, we do need to import gym, and then we do need the environment equal to gym dot make card hole V0 and then we do need the env dot reset and inside that we need to for I in range 1000 env dot render. We do need to install the package gem, so pip install open AI gem. It's already installing the gem, so that is good. Environment dot render, and then we do need to environment dot step. So in here we'll take two parameter, self and action. So the step is the environment.step, so we only import the action, so action spy dot sample, and inside we just leave for empty. So after introducing the environment, we will move on to the practical use. So we will I think this one we don't need that. So we do need to explain in here. So let me explain the code. So in here we just import the environment. And then the make method creates the environment that our agent will run. So an environment is a problem with a minimal interface, and then so let's talk about the environment in here is better. So is the dot an agent can interact with. So we initialize the newly set environment by resetting it using the reset method. So this one should be in here, and so an initial observation is returned. So this value represents our initial state. So at this point we will use a for loop to run an instance of the card pole v0 environment for 1000. steps and rendering. I think I just delete the end. Rendering the environment at each step. So I just get rid of this. Save and calling the render method will visually display the current state while subsequent calls to env.step will allow us to interact with the environment, returning the new stasis. In response to the actions with which we call it. So in this way we have adopted random actions at each step. So at this point, it is certainly useful to know what actions we are doing, what to know what action we are doing on the environment to decide future action. So the step method returns exactly this. So in effect, this method will return the four values. So I think this video is a little bit long. We'll stop here and we'll continue this in the next video, and I will see you in the next video.